He's an all-star. He's a gent. And I wouldn't be here without you, man. I thank you. Still, I would have shared the raft.
Raft, door, regardless, there was room for Jack on it, okay? Brad Pitt saying what Titanic fans have long debated ever since the movie premiered back in 1997. Now get ready to relive this classic for this week's CBS Sunday Night Movie. But before that, we've got some things you never knew.
Doing the Titanic, and it's sort of the same, you know, everyone sort of dies at the end, so it's not really shipper. It's so hard, you know, I'm sitting there handcuffed to a pipe, water's come up to my neck.
I'll just wait here.
I'm saying, what the hell am I doing here? Can I do some light, fluffy comedy or something?
I'm the king of the world!
It's one of the most famous declarations in movie history, and it was ad-libbed on the spot.
King of the world, is that the term?
Yeah.
Never live that one up, down.
And here's something you might not know about this scene.
Jack, I want you to draw me like one of your French girls.
I think it was our first day of work, if I remember correctly. The poor girl had to, you know, be completely naked in front of me, you know, in front of the whole sort of crew. And it was like jumping right into it, you know, for her.
Go on, I'll get the next one.
No, not without you.
The thing that made me begin to cry and then not stop crying till the end of the film was the scene when I'm going down in the lifeboat and looking up at Leo and we're looking at each other and both crying, and then I jumped back onto the ship. That was the point at which I began to let the tears tumble down my cheeks and didn't stop crying until the end.
No one but Celine Dion could have belted out Titanic's iconic theme song, but could you imagine? Tom Cruise, Matthew McConaughey, Johnny Depp, and Christian Bale all auditioned for the role of Jack. And as for Rose, Gwyneth Paltrow, Claire Danes, Uma Thurman, and Winona Ryder tried out for the part. But check out this scene when Titanic airs on CBS this Sunday. It wasn't as romantic to shoot as it looks.
I'm flying, Jack.
It really did take a lot to get it absolutely right. And so take after take after take after take, and to be honest with you, by the end of it, we just thought, oh God, we can't kiss each other anymore. It just got so boring, and I had his makeup on me, and he had my makeup on him. And then you see the final thing, and it's really extraordinary. It does take your breath away.
But we think the best thing Titanic gave us is one of our favorite Hollywood friendships.
The minute we met, we just totally clicked. We once tried to have an argument because we realized we'd never argued, and we just ended up laughing, and it didn't really happen.
You are so annoying.
We've remained such great friends throughout the years, and she's sort of mastered her craft, you know, through the course of these years, and to becoming, you know, one of the finest actresses of our time, and it's amazing to watch.
I floods of tears.
It's one of the most famous scenes in cinematic history.
I'm flying.
But it's not as simple as it looks, and only E.T. has the story behind the stunning moment.
Why don't we take a look?
Titanic is arguably one of the most important movies of all time, partially because James Cameron's aquatic epic has no shortage of iconic moments.
When I first saw myself on screen, when it was there's a top shot of me in the big purple hat and look up at the camera like that, I just thought, what am I doing in this film? I mean, that's not really me.
While Kate Winslet and Leonardo DiCaprio's characters only share a few days together, Jack and Rose's romance is one of movie history's all-time greatest love stories.
So you want to go to a real party?
The love story I knew was going to be what the audience was connected to. You know, the first 2 hours is mainly about these two characters and becoming emotionally attached to them. And that's why the tragedy is, you know, so powerful at the end.
So, how did Cameron tell such a powerful love story in that short amount of time? Well, you can thank that one famous scene.
Give me your hand.
In a movie full of groundbreaking visual effects, some real-life magic was actually at play during that breathtaking moment.
We had incredible luck with that sunset. I mean, literally, we got up there and we thought, well, this will just be a good rehearsal for us and we'll have to shoot it another day. And at the last second, the clouds kind of parted.
And the sun was going down. It was a beautiful sky. And so the sky that you see is the sky that we shot.
As soon as she saw the sunset, Winslet snapped into action on set.
and this beautiful sunset started to happen, and Kate was up there and she was screaming down at us, you know, at the camera, shoot it, shoot it, you know, and Leo's running up there, and they came together and we had very little time to rehearse.
I'm flying.
And then you see the final thing, and it's really extraordinary. It does take your breath away. It certainly took mine away when I saw it.
This scene also became the icon of Titanic's mega successful marketing campaign. The movie set a new box office record, grossing $1.8 billion worldwide.
We expected it to be something. I had no idea it would be this magnitude. I mean, it's truly overwhelming.
And scored 11 wins at the Academy Awards. And I'm looking to the sky to save me. As with all famous movie moments, there's also been countless reenactments, even by the stars themselves.
Am I flying, Jack? Yes, Rose.
What?
Jack, I feel like I'm flying.
All in all, Cameron helped close out cinema's first century with a scene that will, well, go on forever.
It was just one of those magical moments that happens, you know, once in a movie, maybe once in a lifetime.